What is up, my friends? Matt Hall here, and in this video, I want to talk to you a little bit about promoting events. Events are, without a doubt, the most powerful, maybe transformative thing that you have at your disposal in your business other than your products, okay? So your product is number one. Your product is where the transformation should be happening, where people should be creating fidelity, loyalty, retention, and should be the focus of any good business. The focus should be a good product. The product is not a good compensation plan, right? A good compensation plan pays you well from the promoting of a good product. Now, let's talk about events. Probably the second most powerful thing at your disposal. And I'm sorry for the saw that's cutting tile behind me, but I'm just gonna keep talking and work with what I've got. So events are incredible. I'm doing events here in Brazil during the 2 months that we're here. I'm literally in the typical is in four different states every single week. I'm literally killing myself doing this tour because one, our team here is so new. Two, there's so much momentum, so many people that need to be trained. And three, because it accelerates momentum like nothing else. You can build 100% online your business if you want to. I do a ton online, but doing these sprints and doing events, physical events, is incredibly powerful. And if all you have at your disposal, if all you can do right now is really work, really promote your company, leadership events, your regional events, and your convention, work with what you've got, okay? And get as many people to those events as you possibly can. Now, when I say events, sometimes people only think about those big events. And yeah, everybody talks about, hey, you know, you get as many people as you can to your convention. They're gonna have a transformative experience. They're gonna have, their belief is gonna go out the roof. And a good percentage of them are gonna commit like they wouldn't have committed before and build a business more than they would have built had they not gone. But what I wanted to talk about in this video is actually your small events, your home parties, your home events, your business presentations, your hotel events, however it is that you do it. In the events that we're doing here in Brazil, I'm literally sharing almost the exact same content everywhere that I go. But we're promoting each event as if it's this amazing thing, right? And there's something to be learned from this, even with your home events. Like if you're not inviting people to your home event, if your invite's like, hey, you know, I know that you're interested in this kind of a product. I really think you should come. We're gonna be talking about this, this and that, and I think you'll love it. Will you come? It's for sure, it's likely you'll get somebody, but not the majority, right? Each event, you are a marketer, right? So as a marketer, one of your jobs is to create interest, create curiosity, create excitement around the movement that you're a part of, right? So each and every single event you do, whether it's a training for your team on Zoom, whether it's a home party or a home event, it should be a big deal. It should be a big deal. And as you're inviting people from your team or prospects to participate, you need to find what it is about the event that's special. And if there's nothing special, then you need to make it special, right? And so if somebody's coming that doesn't normally teach on a training or to a home party or an event, you need to build up that person, edify that person as much as you possibly can. Sometimes we get used to this. Everybody knows that you're supposed to edify your upline, edify the presenter, and then they're gonna edify you back, and there's this circle of edification. But as you do it a lot of many times, you kind of fall into a routine of it being mundane. No, you need to believe in yourself and pass on to the person that you're inviting, that the person who's teaching at your home event or the content that's gonna be shared, something that's special about the event is like a once in a lifetime opportunity. That's the kind of feeling that people should have. And then you just build from one event to the next. And even if you're doing home parties and every home party is exactly the same, one, mix it up a little bit, make it a little bit different so that you can share with the people you're inviting why that week, why they need to come, why it's so special, what you're gonna be doing, what the attraction is, what is that piece. So that's a big part of what we do in Network Marketers is, you guessed it, marketing events. And so learn how to market events in a way that's attractive. Learn, wake up your passion, wake up your excitement, wake up your enthusiasm. Passion is transferable. You can literally breathe it into other people through you, through your excitement, through your, through, you know, what you show as you're inviting people, your confidence, your posture, all of that fun stuff. So use your events, get excited, make every event seem super special, and make every event special by the way you show up at the event. And that's it for today. So a few tips around events. Nothing transforms people more than the big events. Build up to those big events. Treat your small events like they're big events in the way that you promote them. Okay, love you guys, bye.